Hello, my name is Chan Choi. I'm working at Samsung Electronics. Today, I have a presentation about the non-CPU device power management by device frequency framework in the Linux kernel. Yeah, as you know, there are many non-CPU devices such as GPU, memory controller, storage, and so on. This talk contains how to develop and optimize the device frequency driver. And this talk has this content, what is device frequency? So I will explain the how to add and optimize the driver and governor. And also there are some collaboration with other frameworks. And I will explain the how to propile and optimize the device by only using kernel feature. And also check the real use case in the mainline kernel. And lastly, I just mentioned the what is weakness and to-do list of the device frequency framework. Yeah, recently embedded devices must require the high quality imaging for high resolution display and picture, and fast data transfer for large size video, and then low latency to access storage. About this, there are a lot of devices related to performance and power management, such as GPU, memory controller, and memory data bus and storage. This device must need too many power to support their requirement. Also, people want to use device for a long time, even if it has the limited battery capacity. It means that need to support DVFS for non-CPU device power management. So, device frequency framework supports power management mechanism in order to keep the balance between performance and power. Traditionally, we almost focus on the CPU device for performance and power. As I said previously, we need to consider non-CPU device. On the left side, there are some framework for CPU. On the right side, show the framework for non-CPU. The runtime PM and generic power domain framework support the dynamic power control for device on and off. And device frequency supports DVFS on same layer with CPU frequency. The device frequency is very similar with the CPU frequency, but it has unique feature. I will explain it on this talk. First of all, check the device frequency internal module. There are three main modules, core, governor, CCFS. The core module contains three sub-modules. The timer is used for monitoring the device periodically in order to check the next frequency and use the monitoring timer. And adjust final frequency, decide the final frequency among the multiple inputs like governor result, user input through CCFS, and interconnect summer. And also, it core support the device frequency suspend mode. And Gamma has two sub-modules, get device status and manage the life cycle of the governor. The governor needs to get device status for deciding the next frequency. And this status is used to decide the next frequency by governor algorithm. And also need to control the governor life cycle and governor list. And this page shows the external relationship of device frequency. So firstly, device frequency must control the clock and power by CCF and regulator framework. The CCF is clock control framework in the mainline Linux kernel. Or you can use OPP interface like operating performance point framework to control the clock and power. It provides a very helpful function to control the clock and power. If you use them, you can reduce your code and you can reduce your mistake. Also, there are some specific device frequency driver with firmware and special device. In this case, you can use SMCCC or direct register access for their specific device. The SMC is the secure monitor core to control the secure OS or firmware. And also, power management quality of service provide the interface to control the minimum and maximum frequency for each device. The external driver and external user can change the minimum and maximum frequency for device frequency. And when receiving the multiple input from the various framer, PMQS will pass the final min or max frequency to device frequency. It looks like an arbiter. So interconnect and summer C-surface interface use the PMQS to inform their requirement. On later chapter, I will explain the detailed operation of each module, how to do, and how to collaborate with other frameworks. And this chapter explains how to add device frequency driver and governor. The device frequency driver supports DVFS by controlling clock and voltage according to device status with governor. The mainline corner already consists of the kind of device frequency driver, like a GPU for rendering, the memory bus to transfer data, and memory controller, and storage for UFS, universal flash storage. And recently, L2 cache driver was posted to mainline corner, but has not yet merged, just under review. For driver, the developer needs to implement the device frequency, device profile structure. It is mandatory. You need to implement the target and get device status and list. And also, this structure includes another function and variable. The target function changes the clock and voltage or execute the SMC call to control the firmware for changing the hardware resource like clock and voltage. And also get device status, return the current device status. This result is used for governor. And then you need to get hardware information from device tree and choose the governor, like simple on-demand, performance, and user space. And lastly, you just add your device frequency driver to subsystem. Yeah, it is finished. It is very simple. And there are one thing, if you want to control the frequency by OPP interface, you need to add register OPP notifier with the device frequency helper function. Yeah, this page explains the details of device frequency, device profile structure. The user can initialize the five variables when implementing the driver, and also there are four functions, target and get device status are mandatory, as I mentioned. The polling millisecond timer affect the timer monitoring for simple on-demand governor, and the up threshold and down differential affect the frequency scaling speed on the governor. Yet these four variables are tuning points for governor behavior. And also, the governor is deciding next frequency by governor algorithm. Governor has their unique algorithm. Generally, we use the already defined governor like CPU frequency and CPU idle framework, but device frequency framework allows you to add your device own governor. It is key point. As you know, the non-CPU device has not any standard hardware specification. It is very difficult to support on non-CPU device with already defined governor. For instance, the main icon already has the reference for device own governor, like Tegra Actimon driver for NVIDIA Tegra SoC. It is the advantage of device frequency, and it makes device frequency more flexible and extensible. Just to check the step to add governor. Firstly, need to initialize structure, device frequency governor structure. Yeah, there are mandatory variable, a name, and get target frequency and event handler functions. So firstly, get target frequency function have to include the governor algorithm for deciding the next frequency. It is the key function. You have to develop it mandatory. And event handler function handle the life cycle of governor. There are governor event like governor start, stop, suspend, resume. As I say, two functions are mandatory. If you want to add your governor, you have to develop the two functions at least, and just add governor. After that, any device frequency driver can use this governor. device frequency governor structure contains the name, attribute, flag, and two functions. The name indicates the governor name and governor CCFS attribute flag. The basically common CCFS attributes are provided for all devices. Instead, some CCFS attributes have to be initialized when adding governor according to governor characteristic and feature. The lastly, governor feature flag. For example, if governor has immutable flag, this governor is never changeable to other governor through the CCFS interface. So for example, passive and toggle actimon governor are immutable. This is an example to add device on governor for Tegra Actimon governor. So firstly, attribute, this use poly interval CCFS interface to change the period of interrupt. Even if it use poly interval, but it doesn't use the timer. And next, the flag include the immutable and interrupt driven. It means that you use the interrupt method instead of timer method. And also, get target frequency, as I said, it includes the Tegra own governor key algorithm to decide the next frequency according to current device status. We need to add the device own governor for your non-CPU device. And lastly, event handler manager control the life cycle of this governor. In summary, it is immutable and is working with the interrupt method instead of timer, and also it has the device on governor. And also, I recommended device governor need to support the life cycle for device frequency governor event, start, stop, and others. And also, governor module control them. And basically, if you use a simple on-demand governor, require the monitoring timer, and it will be run periodically. So, run timer, and when timer is expired, it required to get target frequency from governor. And then, in the governor module, get the current device status from device frequency driver. And then, governor decide the next frequency by using governor algorithm, current device status. And then return the target frequency to core. And lastly, the core adjusts the frequency with multiple input like governor result, PMQS, and OPP input, and set final frequency to device frequency driver. And also there are some CCFS interface for tuning point about the governor and timer method. And also if you external user want to change the minimum and maximum frequency outside, user can use the PMQS requests and the OPP. And also, I will explain it more detailed on later. And also, as I say, you can add your own device governor. It is very key point. For more detailed, simple on-demand governor with this diagram, the simple on-demand handler is for handling the governor event for lifecycle. And simple on-demand function has a key algorithm for this governor. It will decide the proper frequency by using the current device status. And lastly, each governor can choose the CCFS interface. Surely the common CCFS interface are provided for all governor. As you know, performance, power save, user space governor is not special, it is general governor. So this page shows the passive governor. The passive governor depends on parent device behavior, such as other device frequency device or CPU. If device frequency device use the passive governor, they cannot decide the next frequency by themselves. It always requires a parent device instance. Just show the pattern of the between passive and parent device. The first, if device A is the parent device and change the frequency on parent device, and then send notification to passive device. And lastly, passive device receive the notification and then decide the next frequency by using the parent device result. Like this, passive device depends on the behavior of a parent device. Yeah, I add the example of passive governor use case on Samsung Exynos 5422 SoC is included in the Android X3 target. It has the various AMBA AXI bus. It is data bus to transfer the data between memory and device. It has the 15 AXI data bus, but they share the one power, even if each bus is working along with separate clock. Because of this hardware constraint, it requires a passive governor. In result, only one bus device control share power, and then remaining bus control the frequency according to result of parent device. Like this case, we can use passive governor if passive device depends on parent device. And this chapter explains the CCFS interface. Yeah, this page shows the common CCFS interface for all devices. The governor indicates current governor name, and available governor show the available governor list multiple. But if governor is immutable, this node shows the only current governor name because the governor is not changeable if governor is the immutable. And the available frequency show the available frequency list, and current frequency and mean frequency and max frequency are very useful to check the frequency change and current frequency. Also, user can change the minimum and maximum frequency for their requirement. Lastly, transition statics node shows the frequency transition statics and timing state. It is very useful for simple profile of device. This page shows non-common CCFS interface. Each governor can choose the needed CCFS node. Timer has two type: timer, deferable, and delayed. The polling interval changes the timer interval. If you want to check the current status more frequently, you just down the interval value. And up threshold and down differential are related to frequency up, down, and speed. Yeah, frequency scaling speed. If you want to increase your frequency more fastly for more fast response, just down the up threshold value. Like this, you can tune this value for your circumstance and environment. Yeah, this tab shows the summary for all governor, what with the attribute and governor features. When you are adding your device governor, you can choose the needed attribute and feature like immutable and IRQ driven. And this feature explains the collaboration with other framework like OPP, PMQS, Interconnect, and Summer framework. Yes, yeah. Why need to use the other framework like PMQS, Summer framework, and others? There are simply two reasons. One, boosting for high performance, and two, limiting the frequency to prevent high temperature or reduce the redundant power. Through the PMQS, user can set the min and max frequency for their requirement to device frequency. And through OPP, user can disable and enable the specific frequency. Like this, the PMQS disable the minimum and maximum frequency. And OPP disable some specific frequency. And then just the device frequency only can use the 5 or better frequency. So on the final stage, device frequency adjust the final frequency and then set frequency to device frequency driver. And this mechanism provides the external user for easy control of some hardware resource. It is very easy to guarantee their requirement. And OPP is mandatory for device frequency framework. We provide a function to get clock and regulate the information from device 3. And support the help function to control them. It's more simple and easy for control the resource. Also, this help function has some more good exception handling code. So I recommend you use the OPP helper function to control the clock and voltage. And also it showed the simple example how to enable and disable the OPP entry. If you call the OPP disable with a specific frequency, these frequencies are not available on device frequency. And also again, you can just OPP enable function with a specific frequency. This frequency is available on device frequency core. According to your requirements, you can use the OPP. And power management quality of service framework provide the interface to control the hardware resources as I command. User can reflect their minimum and maximum requirement. On device frequency, only use the min and max frequency control because the PMQS already has the another type resource control like latency, but only device frequency use the min and max frequency control. I just add a simple example how to use the PMQS. The first, if you want to update the PMQS request, you just add a request and checking the request status, active or not, and then just update the request with your specific frequency. And on the device frequency side, device frequency core will receive the notification from PMQS about the update and just read the value and then set the frequency. So for this step, device frequency can set the send apply the usual requirement. And when also you want to release the PMQS, just update with zero and then remove request. It is very easy, but it is very strong and powerful. I recommend you to guarantee and to keep your performance or power requirement. An interconnect framework, it controls the interconnect node. Interconnect node like a memory data bus and memory controller in the SoC. It is very similar with the device frequency, but the interconnect has not any governor mechanism like device frequency. Instead, interconnect make the pass between the interconnect node. So you can set some requirement to the pass from someone interconnect node to and interconnect node. Also, it affects the performance and power management. So some case, it is used with device frequency driver. I add 2 cases for NXP, IMX, and Samsung Exynos memory bus example. The IMX device frequency driver register platform device or interconnect platform driver. And then interconnect driver probe and will create the interconnect node and pass between the node. Actually, device frequency and interconnect are working with separately, but in this case, if when user requires any frequency change to interconnect node and interconnect pass on the final stage, the interconnect requires the frequency change to device frequency driver through the power management quality of service interface. So as I commented, there are 2 examples, but the actual case is not yet merged, just under review. And the thermal support to prevent the high or danger of temperature. It is very important on high flagship embedded device like smartphone. As you know, that GPU has a high frequency. It means that it might make the target the high temperature if you use the for a long time target. In this case, the thermal framework is necessary with GPU. The thermal framework provides some mechanism. We can register device frequency device as a cooling device. Basically, when device arrive at the fixed temperature, just drop the frequency. It is simple, but it is not smart. So recently, the summer framework provides the smart governor. The almost high frequency target uses the intelligent power allocator governor. It is based on the energy model framework, and on this case, it collaborates with device frequency framework. IPA considers the estimated power of device and allocated power budget. In result, it sustained the stable performance without sudden performance drop, like a simple summer governor, as I commented. And also when changing the frequency, someone used the PMPS interface. Already we register the device frequency driver and device as the cooling device. It is the very important case for sustain the performance without any high temperature. And this diagram just shows the relationship between IPA energy model and device frequency. Just you can check it. So recently, there are a lot of rich propylene tools, but actually it needs to make the environment and with the extra effort. So in my case, I prefer to use the simple propylene by only using the color feature, people using the any rich propylene tools. If I catch the problem with the simple propylene, and then I try to use the rich propylene tools. On this chapter, I just the simple propylene and how to optimize the behavior of a device frequency driver. So firstly, check the all supported device on target through the debug FS. The debug FS summary node shows the all supported device frequency. And also, next, SysFS shows the very simple profiling. You can just make the simple shell script to print the current or min and max frequency periodically, and then run benchmark tool. You can simply check the frequency change variation and history. And so also it is possible to check the how to affect the performance from your modification and tuning. Usually I use this method. Yeah, as I know it is not correct, but on the early stage, it is very useful to catch the what is problem and why frequency is not changed. Yeah, it is very good. Yeah, if you want to check the more detailed and want to check the frequency width of the operation like V-blank and video flag and storage access, you better to use the trace point. And lastly, in some case, we need to check the power status of device. If the power status of device is suspended, it is not working. Yeah. The user can check the all device frequency device information through the debugger FS node. It's very useful when need to check them at once. And on this example, Odroid XU3 with Samsung SoC, this target includes 17 non-CPU devices, and one GPU, and one memory controller, and 50 memory data bus. The one memory bus is the parent device, and remaining memory bus use the passive governor. So you can check the all information through this node. It is very useful. And also, in case of SysFS, minimum and maximum frequency and current frequency, as I said, to check the current device status, you just make the simple shell script to print the frequency periodically. Yeah, as I said, it is not the correct, I know, but it is very simple profiling on the early stage. And translate the statics node, show the transient statics and timing each frequency, timing state. Actually, in my case, this node is very useful when I want to know what my tuning and code changes is how much it affect the performance. So how to use it for performance properly? Firstly, you can check the frequency list and the timing state. And just with original code and just reset trans and statics and read timing state and execute your tool. And then after finish the program, just read the timing state. And you can calculate the difference timing state between before and after. And also again, after tune and optimize your code, and again to do the same case. And after finished all estimate, you can compare two timing state is to check the your changes, how much it affect the performance. Yeah, we cannot get any correct trace point and some jump information, but we can catch the my code change is how much affect the performance and others. It's very useful. After this, if you want to know the more detailed properly, you can use TracePoint. If you want to want to profile device more detailed, there are some TracePoint in device frequency, summer, and PMQS framework. User can check the detailed frequency change and monitoring point. The monitoring actually depend on the timer type. And also, when the required frequency is enough, but there are some performance drop, you might guessing the summer throttling or too many device operation from other requests. So you can check these operations through the summer trace point. And also, to check the summer throttling, you can use the summer trace point. And lastly, you can catch the who changed the frequency and the correct change timing. This page explains the more detailed trace point. The first device frequency monitor just show the when device monitoring is executed by timer. Yeah, it is very used to check the how often it has been monitored. And also, the second device frequency show frequency change point. It is useful for determining whether or not the frequency has changed at the proper timing and checking the history of frequency change. And on the summer case, the summer trace point show the temperature and some throttling happened, the summer trace point printed summer zone trip trace point. And then, as I said, we can see the QS request point with the request value with device PMQS update request. In my case, I usually this trace point for profiling device frequency. If you want to know your change is how much affect the performance, you just enable the trace point of device frequency, PMQS, summer, and then enable the trace point of performance sensitive device like DRM, V4H, and storage trace point. For example, if 60 FPS is required on display, each wavelength interrupt must happen within 16 milliseconds. You can check the wavelength latency with the device frequency. So maybe you might catch the problem about the device frequency. So firstly, check the interval between the two wavelengths. If the interval is over 60 milliseconds on 60 FPS, you check the frequency of non-CPU device before and wavelength in interrupt. And if a frequency is low, after increasing the frequency through the PMQS, and you can try to check the wavelength again. And also, you can check the timing when QoS is required at the proper timing. After checking the QoS timing, you might require the QoS more early than before or later. Also, it is able to check the frequency change and thermal temperature and throttling. Voila. This example has a very simple case, but just I shared how to use the trace point for your circumstance. And the previous example, actually I catch the result on the Eldred X3. There are the GPU, but we cannot read any GPU monitoring. So we need to check the power status of GPU. So in this case, I use the runtime PM and general power domain. So this page shows the general power domain debugger summary on the Eldred X3. Like this, the GPU is suspended. So the monitoring of GPU is not working, even if it used the simple on-demand with the timer-based method. Like this, the device frequency framework provides a hyperfunction to control the governor status for device. By using them, you can reduce the unneeded monitoring like GPU on the suspend state. And on the active state, you can restart your governor. It is very helpful for power management. And also, timer has two type timer. The deferable timer is not expired if CPU idle, and delayed timer doesn't care CPU status. And polling interval and change timer interval, it is short, very fast response. If it is long, save the power by preventing the frequency and frequent wake up of CPU. And off threshold and down differential affect the frequency scaling speed. So you can change for this value by for the tuning. And explain the difference between the deferable and delayed timer. And firstly, deferable timer is not expired on CPU idle status. The postpone timer will be wake up on the next CPU wake up time. So it doesn't wake up CPU time from idle, so it saves the power, but it has the low response if CPU is idle state. And secondly, delayed timer doesn't care the CPU idle status. It runs the timer when fixes the timer interval. And also it wake up the CPU from the idle state, but it provides more fast response than deferable timer. Actually, if on the flagship mode like a smartphone, I recommend to use the delayed timer with a short period because the wake up cost is not critical. But on the IoT side, I recommend you use the deferable timer because the small wake up cost is some critical on the IoT side because IoT device has the very low capacity battery. Yeah, you can choose the timer type according to your environment. And add the example of deferable timer bad case on DMA operation. The simple on-demand governor with deferable timer changes the frequency according to the amount of DMA operation. But when DMA operation is busy and CPU is idle status, the deferable timer is not expired in the idle state. So the timer cannot check the DMA operation. In result, the performance will happen because timer has not check the current status. It is just example to explain the different timer. So as I say, you can choose the timer type according to your environment, like IoT site or some flagship model like a smartphone. And this table show the how much affect the device behavior when you change the value through the CCFS. So when you try to tuning this, so you can report this table. And also this table contains some guide how to tune the value on each scenario. But it is not always true, just it is my recommend. So like this, you can make the value set according to your environment for tuning. If you use this variable, I think that it is very useful to keep the balance, performance, and power of CPU over non-CPU device. And this chapter explain some mainline kernels device driver. And there are five category device driver: the GPU and ARM unbiased bus, dynamic memory controller, and storage, universal flash storage, and L2 cache. But it is not on the review. And there are 11 device frequency driver and 5 type non-CPU device in the mainline corner. You can report this driver, and also you can add your device for non-CPU device. But almost except for Tegra, Actimon governor, almost driver use the simple on-demand governor. But actually it is too old governor, so I think we need to improve the simple on-demand governor and have to suggest a new governor. If you have any idea, please send the patches to the mainline corner. And lastly, I just simply quickly mentioned weakness and to-do list. Yeah, as I said, the device frequency framework have the too old governor. So, in order to optimize the performance and power, we already provided some tuning points like up threshold, down differential, timer type, and falling interval. But I think it needs the new governor for fast response, like scheduled governor on the CPU frequency subsystem. And also, it is too simply checking the device status at the time without any history. So it don't expect the future device status. So some performance drop happen. So I think that the device frequency framework need to some other load tracking methodology, like per entity load tracking of CPU scheduler or radar governor of a CPU idle framework. And this page showed some further to-do list. Firstly, the support required OPP property of OPP for the passive governor. And also, until now, passive governor only support with other device frequency driver, but I will expand the passive governor depend on the CPU frequency. So in the mainline kernel, there are some requirements about this, but it has not yet completed. I will. And also for more immediate response, support K-thread based timer. So until now, just support deferable worker queue or delayed worker queue. And then I will support K-thread for each device. And also, lastly, I think need to KTF test for framework. Yeah, thank you. I finished my presentation, and thanks coming for my session. And if you have any question, please let me know through the email and on the mailing list. Yeah, thank you.